is gonna take crackerjack timing, Wang. Total concentration. You ready, Jack? I was born ready.
DC Comics' flagship character Batman and IDW Publishing's most popular title, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, come together for one last adventure this week. Series like Batman Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3 really make me wish more publishers were willing to cross over fan favorite characters and series. I get these kinds of series are fan service, but when done right, they're a ton of fun and a great change of pace. Batman Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3 is once again led by writer James Tynion IV and artist Freddie Williams II. I'm a huge fan and supporter of the first series. It's a great crossover that uses an all-too-familiar comic trope, the portal to another dimension. The premise is played for fun, and it was pure joy in my opinion. The second series was much less than the first. It basically recycled the premise, but added even more characters and bloated the roster. It was okay. The relationship between Michelangelo and Damian stood out, but other than that, it was pretty bland. Thankfully, the creative team are taking the final crossover in a much fresher direction, and Volume 3 turns everything on its head. The one constant in the previous series is Freddie Williams II's phenomenal artwork, and the third go-around brings more of the same. It's an absolute crime against comic book fans that in the day of watered-down writing and Tumblr art, Freddie Williams isn't flying his flag on a major book. The big two should be driving the Brinks truck to his house to secure him exclusively on a flagship title. Can you imagine how much better Nightwing would be with Freddie as the visual architect? Marvel has so many titles with substandard artwork, it's embarrassing. Pair him with a great writer on a Miles Morales Spider-Man series. Maybe then Marvel can capitalize on the squandered success of Into the Spider-Verse. Look at this amazing detail and how badass he draws Batman here. Freddie Williams deserves a much bigger spotlight. Freddie's visuals are so unique, even the character poses are immediately identifiable as his. And let's not forget his partner in crime, Jeremy Caldwell. His color work looks perfectly paired with Freddie's stunning line art. He's got so many tricks up his sleeve now, it's not even fair. Freddie's action is always dynamic and impactful. He fills his world with so much detail, it's hard to imagine he does this all by hand. And man, can he emote character faces. Freddie Williams II is a brilliant artist. He was born to draw this series. I rate the art in Batman Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3, Issue 1, 5 out of 5. It's absolutely brilliant. In 2019, I've seen so many amazing DC comic artists saddled with substandard writing. It's not even funny. That is not the case here. James Tynion IV and DC Comics really dropped the ball by rehashing the same story, but in reverse for Volume 2. Tynion doesn't make the same mistake here and changes everything up to provide a fresh story with some outstanding twists. Normally, I break writing down by characterization and plot. The characterization is basically a plot in this book, so I'm combining them this issue. There is a robbery going on, but it's merely a vessel to introduce readers to this very cool new world. We're immediately introduced to the Smile Clan and Harley Quinn. Amongst her henchmen are Clayface and Killer Croc, looking very much like Rocksteady and Bebop. Batman and his brothers, the Turtles, arrive, and they all look a little different. Raphael has a Jason Todd vibe to him, which makes sense as they're both the gruff bad boys of the bunch. Donatello is playing the Tim Drake role, both geniuses. Mikey is dressed in Damian Wayne's Robin Hood and cape. They're both the free spirits of the tribes. Leonardo is of course Dick Grayson, as they both hold outstanding leadership traits and are the most trustworthy. The leader of the Smile Clan is the Laughing Man, a mashup of Shredder and Joker. During the encounter, the Laughing Man is holding the meteorite the Smile Clan is stealing. Batman seems to recognize the Joker. Something is amiss, and it appears Batman and Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles universes have crossed into each other. You just have to love this beautiful art. Laughing Man looks absolutely insane here. The Laughing Man has no clue what Bats is talking about and says, "I'm no Joker, Batman. I'm deadly serious." He blows the ceiling, and Batman is too injured to stop the Smile Clan's escape. Batman and his turtle brothers head back to their lair, injured but ready to fight another day. Outside the building, Commissioner Gordon gets a sit-rep from a young police officer, Casey Jones. During the encounter, the Laughing Man reveals he bought off Gordon's entire department, and Jones is the only officer not to take the money. During the exchange, Gordon says, "You ever get the feeling that the world is wrong, Casey?" Indeed. Back at their lair, we meet Splinter, who is playing the role of Alfred. Batman reveals he's distracted by dreams. He can feel something is wrong with the world. We also learn Splinter found Bruce after his parents' murder and raised him in the sewer. He trained him and his brothers to keep the city safe. The ragtag crew are interrupted by an unknown visitor who states, "The pieces of the world aren't in the right place." There are a couple of huge reveals after this, but I don't want to spoil it all. Tinian is on top of his game here and expertly introduces readers to a very mad world. I rate the writing 4 out of 5. This is a supremely enjoyable beginning to the finale of the Batman Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles crossovers. I'm on the fence whether this is better than Volume 1. Only time will tell. It's refreshing to see amazing artwork elevate a great story rather than save a terrible one. I rate Batman Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 3 4.5 out of 5 overall. I give this issue my highest recommendation, and anyone looking for an action-packed adventure will be very satisfied. There's a lot wrong with comics right now, but there are great series still out there. Make sure you support this book. The industry needs to know this is the kind of quality we as readers demand. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. I would appreciate it very much. It helps us attract more views for the channel. Subscribe for future commentary, comic book news, and reviews. And don't forget to ring the bell for notifications. If you want to talk comics, movies, and much, much more, you can follow me on Twitter at Wes_from_TC. With that, Salamat Po, and I'm out.